Welcome, disciples of Seth. We live in truly remarkable times. Our god has been called back to life in order to lead us. The pharaoh, Ramses II, will himself swear allegiance. Seth has returned to show us the way and to set in motion the creation of a new Egyptian empire that will dominate the world. The title of supreme deity belongs to Seth, and not to that damned Horus. We shall journey to a country where heretic barbarians worship false gods. The strength of these impostors is nothing compared to that of Seth. His powerful magic allows us to arrive in the midst of our enemies without warning, to hit them by surprise. Pass through his door and let us wipe these heathens from the face of the earth. Then we can proclaim year one of Seth's reign.
The path that you follow is dangerous. Be careful that it does not cost you your life. It exercises a strong hold on you, and it is the way of least resistance. But do not let it corrupt you and lead you to a sorry end. You must not remain here. To put you out of harm's way, I shall send you to the village of Sherasen. Once there, we shall decide what to do.
Seth's cult has greatly changed. Yesterday I was a priest, extolling the virtues of a strong but fair-minded king. Today, I am a murderer, killing in the name of a god whose sole motive is vengeance. This carnage is necessary to build a strong empire. Sacrifices must be made. I dream of a strong and proud Egypt. There are too many tribes fighting to gain a short-lived domination. We must install unity and peace.
I am Isis, the goddess of light. I show myself to you in order to offer you guidance. You desire a strong king, not a bloodthirsty tyrant. You must understand that the village you just destroyed does not belong to your world. You can't even begin to understand the repercussions of what you have done. Why do you think that Seth is attacking people that have nothing to do with Egypt?
I've got things so completely wrong. No, it can't be possible.
The path that you have chosen does not correspond with your ideals, noble priest. Your god has been corrupted by his own power. If his plans succeed, nothing good will come out of them for Egypt. The truth is staring you in the face. Let my light open your eyes.
Help me, Mother Goddess. Show me the light and give me the strength to make the right choice. I want to take control of my destiny once again. And I want to do what my conscience dictates. I alone will decide my future. Mektub, it is written.
I'd like to have definite proof that Seth is truly back among us. He hasn't been seen since the Council of Gods banished him many years ago. Is Seth really behind all this? go to Seth's tomb and enter the burial chamber. There you will be able to see with your own eyes whether Seth has truly returned.
I have a request of you. The potion that I am making is lacking vital ingredients. Find me the sting of a scorpion, the leg of a scarab beetle, and the skin of a desert worm. Once I have them, I can finish my work.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. You have brought back what I asked of you. Take this as a way of thanks. I study ancient artifacts, and there is one object that I particularly desire. It is a heart scarab, a very rare jewel. But it is said that they are placed on certain mummies. You must visit several tombs and find one for me. If you bring me a heart scarab, I...
Forlorn. Thank you.
Seth's tomb is empty. He has truly come back to life. It was locked tight by powerful magic, and only a mighty force could have broken the seals. I don't know who or what could have done such a thing, but it stretches far beyond anything the disciples of Seth are capable of. Secret passageway in the tomb that will take you into the old temple. We must get to the bottom of this.
Thank you. Thank you.